Welcome everyone. So we are in the lesson 5 in the same bridge course, same basics we are learning. So unit 5, we are having unit 4, the same usages is going to continue with some other cases and all. Let us see. Yes, today we are going to learn some main words or nouns, whichever you call, no problem. You know now what is noun, what is the verb, all those things you know. Today we are learning some new words, or mainly usages, whatever the usages, like maybe animals names, all these things we are going to see, and some pronouns. We have learned some saha, eshaha kind of pronoun. With that, some more we are going to see today, and then tritiya vibhakti, third one, like prathama dvitiya we have learned. Now tritiya vibhakti, which is instrumental, as well as chaturthi we are going to learn, which is dative clay case. So two cases we are going to learn today, and some important verbs also. At the last part of this lesson, I have mentioned some important verbs that also we are going to see, and we are going to take it to the application part. And finally, daily usages. These things will be covered in this today's basic class. Let us start. Yes, as I said, some nouns are main words. In that way, first you can see all animals' names, like animals or birds, whichever. Kuku, which means you know, kokilaha or pikaha. See, whenever you are seeing every word, you need to understand which group or which category, I mean which gender it will be. So dau, kapotaha, ulukaha, kukkutaha, chatakaha, kakaha, gridhaha, it should be gridhraha, okay. Then shukaha, it should be okay, vakaha, mayuraha, vartakaha, then hamsaha and madhupaha. Madhupaha, which means bee or honey bee. Madhupaha, not only bee, honey bee we need to say, okay, honey bee. These many names we have learned, all of them are in male, you know, masculine gender only, because end of the word is having aha, you know that one. But whenever you find a letter which is hrasva swara, not prolonging one, that will go under pullinga. So next we are having some more. Bidalaha, dhenuhu, see, ha, dhenuhu, and then shwanaha, ajaha, balivardaha, shashakaha. This dhenuhu, it is a hraswa swara u only, but also it's an exceptional word, so we have to take it under strilinga, feminine gender, okay, feminine gender. Edaka, sheep. Kachapi, karkataha, makari, mandukaha, chitroshtraha, shambukaha, sarpaha, matsyaha, ashtabhujaha, okay, naradagraha, bhallukaha, murgaha, gajaha, lomashaha. This many of them are there. You can use all of them as nouns whenever you are constructing a sentence. So here, edaka you are finding, edaka and kachapi both also are having, and makari, these three of them are having prolonging letters at the end, a or e, they are showing, they are having as ending letter, which means prolonging letters, so which will come obviously under strilinga. But dhenuhu, even if it is hraswa swara u, this one u, but also we need to consider this as strilinga, because it's an exceptional word. Next, some more. So see here I think all of them are mainly things, but also things are also having genders, as I said in the beginning classes. See, for example, chair, what we call that, asandaha, we call that chair or a seat, whatever the thing, okay, asandaha. And then lock, talaha, dandadipaha, samirakaha, syutaha. See, ending is aha, so all these words will come under masculine gender. You need not to see the things names or meaning, which if I say asandaha, which means chair, but it can be in a neutral gender. No, it cannot be in neutral gender, because in Sanskrit we don't see the things and decide the gender, but the word itself is having the gender. Then agnipetika kara, this is strilinga again, because ending is a. Karadipaha, kataha, pinjaha, darpanaha, nalika, see, again strilinga. Kunjika, strilinga. Duravani, strilinga. Kapatika, again strilinga. Avakarika, again strilinga. chulli strilinga, sammarjani strilinga, padashodhanam strilinga, no, padashodhanam ended with this one. That's the reason. So it will come under what? Neutral gender. This is how we are going to fix a gender for any word. So we should not miss in that way. Padashodhanam, because it ended up with ma. This footrug, yeah, when you see the meaning, then also it will give a neutral gender meaning only. But anyways, word also ended with ma, mean dot or ma, whichever the thing we can take, that is called, or that is, that will come under neutral gender. This is how genders will be fixed for every word in Sanskrit. Next, yeah, you can see here, kankatam, what is that? Shaya, javanika, petika, pushpadhani, upadhanam, then vyajanam. Okay, so here, kankatam, you can find here, then shaya, it's here, then javanika, the curtain, then petika, box, then upadhanam, pillow, okay, vyajanam, fan. Okay, pushpadhani I mentioned, that's over here. So here, kankatam and then upadhanam, vyajanam, these three will come under, yes, neutral gender. Shaya, javanika, petika, pushpadhani, these four things will come under feminine gender. This is how we need to segregate the genders for every, each and every single word. If it is hrasva swara, pullinga. If it is dirgha swara, strilinga. And then if it is this one, what, ma ending, then it will come under neutral gender. That is how we have to fix gender for every word. This is the major rule we should not forget. So if we make some mistake, for example, what will happen generally? Generally, when we start adding adjectives to any word, for example, there is a sentence, I'll write over here, you can find, see, Ramaha Asti. Ramaha Asti I have written. I need to add some adjective. What kind of a Ramaha? I can write Sundara, smart. Okay. If I write Sundaram, then it is wrong. Why? Because noun is in Pullinga. But the adjective is in Napumsakalinga. Then it is wrong. Then adjective also should be in Pullinga only. Then, so this is where we make some mistakes if we don't know how to fix a gender for every word. Let us think, instead of Ramaha, Sita is there. Instead of Ramaha, I am taking Sita. Then how should I use this one? Sundara, Sundaraha. Then Sita Asti, Sita Sundaraha Asti, again wrong. We should not use Sita Sundaraha Asti, but we should use Sita Sundari Asti, E. Then what will happen? Instead of Aha, E has come. So which means Sundari, it will, ending is the prolonging one, so it will tell about what, feminine gender. That is how the usages will be. This is the reason this word ending part is very important, and this gender separation, gender segregation also very important in Sanskrit sentences. Now, as I said, some nouns, sorry, it should be pronoun, some pronouns we are going to learn. Now again, we have read saha, eshaha, all of them. See, for example, if I'm going to tell about this boy, saha kridati, I would have said saha balakaha. But I can say bhavan, bhavan, which means you. Okay, bhavati also you, but for strilinga. Okay, sarvam, which means all. Ayam, which means this boy or he. Iyam, which means she. Idam, which means this. Tat, again, this only. Vayam, we. Yuyam, you all. So, Bhavan and Bhavati, you in singular. Bhavan is singular, you, Bhavan, which means singular for boys. Bhavati, which means you only, but for girls. Girls and boys, which means male and female. Sarvam, all together. There is no gender. So, Sarvam, which means all of them will come under that. Ayam, again, ayam, the word has ended with ma, but we should not say it's a Napumsakalinga word, but ayam, ayam balakaha, which means he is. So this will tell about pullinga. Iyam, again, ending ma is there, but that doesn't mean neutral gender, which means iyam, again, strilinga. idam ending is ma only, but this will go to neutral gender. So this is the difference. Some, as I said, some exceptional cases. So in that exceptional way, all this will be considered as pullinga, strilinga, and napumsakalinga. Tat phalam. So we know that one, it's napumsakalinga only. And vayam means we all. Then yuyam means you all. How to say? For example, bhavan hasati. Here, bhavan hasati. Bhavati, okay, hasati. Or bhavati pashyati, whatever. Then sarvam means you are laughing or you are seeing. And then here also you are laughing, you are playing. Bhavan kridati in that way. So I can say I am also here. I am balakaha kridati. Then third person. I am balakaha hasati. Iyam balika pashyati. Then idam phalam asti. Huh? The same way tat also for phalam only. Tat phalam asti. Then all of us together, if I say vayam krida maha, you know that one. How maha will come? Because can you remember that verb table? Ami plural will be amaha, as I said. Gachami, aham gachami, vayam gachamaha. Okay. Aham gachami, vayam gachamaha. We should not forget this one. Singular and plural. Uyam, again you all. You all, which kind of, what kind of verb will come? We'll see this one, that one later. Okay. So how? For example, here I am, I'll take it as me. So aham likhami, I will write aham likhami. So if I should say, instead of aham, I should say we all of us are doing, then I should not use the word aham. Instead of that, I should use vayam. So vayam and likhami won't be there, but likhamaha will be there. So vayam likhamaha, aham likhami. So this is how we need to use all these pronouns. Then some numbers we need to see. All of them are together only. Shunyam, ekam, dve, trini, chatvari, pancha, 5, shat, sapta, ashta, nama, and 10. What do you call for 10? Dasha. So all of them are here, numbers. So numbers also will be having gender, but some only one rule is there. Till chatvari, till chatvari we will say with gender. For example, in detail we can study later, just for your reference I'm telling. Ekam phalam asti. So if there is a boy, ekaha balakaha asti. If there is a girl, eka balika asti. In that way I am saying trini phalani santi, trayaha balakaha santi, tisraha balikaha santi. The same way chatvari itself is napumsakalinga. Chatvari phalani santi, chatvaraha balakaha santi, and chatasraha balikaha santi. Pancha onwards, only one usage. Pancha phalani, pancha balakaha, pancha balikaha. Whatever we can take there. Pancha, 5, number 5 onwards, all the numbers, all of them will be same as it is. In all three genders, irrespective of genders, we need to use the word as it is. So pancha balakaha or shat balikaha or sapta phalani, in whichever the way we can use them. So you need to practice these numbers. It's very important. Okay, so this also, and all of them will considered as normal usages only. No need to worry for that. So but when we in detail study, we'll see how trini will become tisra in strilinga and trayaha in pullinga. We can see that one later, no need to worry. These are all just numbers. How many are there? That moment I need to say pancha or shat or sapta. In that way I should know the numbers in Sanskrit. Then next part is that usages. Here one more major usage is there. Atra, what is this atra? I'll start from here. Kutra is a question. Kutra, which means where. So here is a question, where. For example, where is shop? There is a question. Kutra shop, which means apanam in Sanskrit. Okay, I'll write apanam. आई कैन आस्क आपणम कुत्र अस्ति और आई कैन आस्क कुत्र आपणम अस्ति वॉट एवर द आंसर विल बी आपणम कुत्र अस्ति इज द क्वेश्चन सो आपणम आई विल टेल अन्यत्र अस्ति अन्यत्र विच मीन्स समवेयर एल्स इट इज नॉट हियर वेर आई एम सीइंग और इन दिस प्लेस और इन दिस एरिया इट इज नॉट इट समवेयर एल्स सो आई शुड यूज अन्यत्र अस्ति ओके देन सर्वत्र वॉट इज आर सर्वत्र मीनिंग एवरीवेर सर्वत्र सो वायु कुत्र अस्ति वायु सर्वत्र अस्ति इट्स एवरीवेर देन तत्र इट इज नॉट हियर इट्स देर इन दैट मोमेंट सो तत्र सो देवालय तत्र अस्ति इफ दिस बॉय इज टेलिंग द आंसर देवालय तत्र अस्ति देन अत्र इज हियर गृहं कुत्र अस्ति गृहं अत्र अस्ति ओके देन सर्वत्र अस्ति वायुः कुत्र अस्ति वायुः सर्वत्र अस्ति देन आपणं कुत्र अस्ति आपणं अन्यत्र अस्ति इट विल टेक ए लॉन्ग रूट फ्रॉम हियर 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 अन्यत्र अस्ति इट इज नॉट हियर एंड इट्स नॉट आई कैनॉट सी दैट दैट शॉप ओवर एनीवेयर ओवर हियर सो विच मीन्स इट इज समवेयर एल्स सो आपणं तत्र अस्ति देन एकत्र विच मीन्स इट्स ए प्लूरल यूसेज हाउ फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई एम आस्किंग सः कुत्र अस्ति बालकः कुत्र अस्ति आई कैन आस्क दैट मोमेंट बालकः तत्र अस्ति अन्यत्र अस्ति ऑल दिस कैन हैपन बट व्हेन आई एम यूजिंग एकत्र विच मीन्स ऑल टुगेदर ओके ऑल सो हियर वी कैन सी इफ आई से जनाः यू नो जनाः व्हाट डस जनाः मीन पीपल जनाः कुत्र कुत्र जनाः जनाः एकत्र दे आर ऑल टुगेदर मे बी अ प्रोग्राम इज गोइंग ऑन सो जनाः कुत्र जनाः एकत्र ऑल टुगेदर दे आर स्टैंडिंग ओके दैट इज हाउ ओनली एकत्र वर्ड विल गिव प्लूरल मीनिंग बट अदर देन एकत्र वर्ड दीस यूसेजेस कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर एनीथिंग प्लूरल और सिंगुलर फॉर एग्जाम्पल हाउ the question would be like this instead of aapanam I can ask aapanani kutra then aapanani tatra aapanani anyatra in that way so graham kutra asti or grahani kutra grahani tatra sarvatra the same way janaha kutra janaha ekatra all together in that way so this is the or these are all the major usages we can start using them atra tatra sarvatra anyatra ekatra and kutra kutra is the questionary word then yes we need to know how to ask questions kim is a word which is a very normal one for everything we can ask kim saha kim karoti tasya nama kim balika kim karoti नो जेंडर अगेन नो जेंडर विदाउट जेंडर वी कैन यूज तत् किम अस्ति सो इन दिस वे वी नीड टू यूज किम देन कह विल गो ओनली फॉर बॉयज अगेन मैस्कुलिन जेंडर सो बालक कह कह हियर इज द एग्जाम्पल आई कैन राइट द सेंटेंस ओवर हियर कह बालक कह बालक सह बालक और सह कह बालक सह राम सह कृष्ण इन दैट वे सेम वे इफ आई आस्क का बालिका और सा बालिका सो दिस इज हाउ कह एंड का विल गो फॉर स्त्रीलिंग एंड सॉरी पुल्लिंग एंड स्त्रीलिंग किम इज फॉर ऑल सेम देन केन बाय व्हाट सी फॉर एग्जांपल समवन इज गोइंग टू स्कूल देन हाउ यू आर गोइंग और बाय व्हाट सो आई एम गोइंग बाय अ बस I am going by car. I am going by scooter, whichever the way. Kena. Then kasmai. If you are giving a pen to someone, then to. So I am writing a letter to my friend. I am giving this book to my friend. So whom are you going to give this book? I am going to give this book to Rama. So in that usage, I should ask kasmai. How? What is that giving means in Sanskrit? Dadati, which means giving. सो कस्मै लेखनीं ददाति और कस्मै पुस्तकं ददाति देन आई शुड से टू होम देन केन गच्छति वाहनेन गच्छामि और वाहनेन गच्छति इन दैट वे सो कस्मात् कस्मात् इट्स लाइक सेपरेटिंग एंड फॉलिंग हाउ सी हियर यू कैन सी someone has see throwing the stone, and then fruits are falling, so they are going away from the tree. So kasmat phalam patati, vrikshat phalam patati, from where? Not only for this, for we can ask, from where are you coming? Where are you coming from? So that moment, I am coming from Bangalore, I am coming from city, I am coming from whatever we say. So I should say, Nagarat agachami, Nagarataha agachami, in that way. We will see the answer part, we can see when we are, how to add that part in our usages, we will see in details. Then kasya, whose? So then how? Ramasya putraha, Krishnasya putraha, or pita, relation actually. So what is the relation between two things or two people? Whichever, like for example, how? So kasya lekhani, kasya pustakam, tasya ramasya pustakam. In that way my answer should be. Then kutra vino, where? Kasmin is also where, but it says a difference between two things. For example, I'll ask kutra here, I'll use kutra. Jalam kutra asti, jalam kutra asti, where is water? Then you can say jalam atra asti. Okay, there are two glasses, okay, one is empty and one is filled. So jalam atra asti, I'll say. Then kasmin jalam asti, so in which glass there is water? Then only in this glass there is water, and on the other glass there is no water. So kasmin jalam asti, atra asmin chashake jalam asti, in that way. So answer part you don't worry, just learn how to ask question. Kutra asti, kasmin asti. Then kada, which says about time. How kada bhavan gachati? Kada. Kada, when are you going? Kada gachati. So when. Then kasmin, again where only. Kasya, whose, I'll write. Then from, kasmai, to whom. Kasmai, which means to whom. Kena, by what. Ka, who, only for girls. Kaha, who, only for boys. Kim, it's general one, which means what. So this is how all these questions usages, how to use these questions, how to construct a sentence by having all these words as questionary words. Now we use some formal usages, for example, to say good morning, to wish someone, and good morning, good night, all these kind of things, and how to welcome someone. These are all formal usage. Generally, we need to do. See, you would have seen outside also some people, they would use, instead of saying good morning, they can say, Shubhodaya, in that way. They are already using. The same way, we are having the usages. Shubhodaya, good morning. Shubha Madhyanam, which means good afternoon. Shubha Sayam, good evening. Shubha Ratrihi, good night. All these four will be there for morning, afternoon, evening and night. These four, okay. Then namaskara means so generally namaskara, namaste we say over here, right? Namaste, namaskara. Then dhanyavada is thanks, thanking someone. And one more, and swagatam, I'm showing here, swagatam is welcome, okay. Swagatam, welcome. Then namaskara over here. Then dhanyavada is here after finishing some work, dhanyavada. So aham janami, which means I know. If you ask a question, some people say, I know. Yes, I know. Yes, aham janami. Here, aham janami. And some people say, aham na janami. I don't know. So here, I don't know. So how to go to a place, maybe? How to go to this area? I don't know. So aham na janami. And I know. Aham janami. This is how. See, for example, it's a general one. No need of any vibhakti, which means the case, or any gender. In that way, generally, we can say. You find a girl, you can say Shubhodaya. You find a boy, you can say Shubhodaya. So the same way, girls, boys, or whichever, irrespective of genders, we are using all these four as normal usages. Shubhodaya, Shubhasayam. Might be a girl or a boy, whoever, male or female, we generally use Shubharatri, Shubhasayam, Shubhodaya in this scenery. Then namaskara, this one is also namaskara and dhanyavada, both of them also. You can say namaskara to a boy, Namaskarah to a girl. The same way, Dhanyavadah also to a girl, Dhanyavadah also to a boy. In that way. Then Swagatam also for anyone. Swagatam. So, Aham Janami, Aham Na Janami. This is also, a girl can say Aham Janami, a boy also can say Aham Janami. The same way, Aham Na Janami concept, they are also boy or girl, anyone, as it is, they can use. It's a sentence. All of them are sentences. So, this is how we need to use all these things generally. If you start using them, it will be there with you. Otherwise, you will forget. So, if someone meets you, you can say Shubodaya in the morning. If you need to say goodnight to someone, then you can say Shubaratrihi. But you need to remember that. See, Ratri, you should not say Ratrihi. Shubodaya, you should not say Shubodayaha. So, we have to have that basic understanding. These are the formal usages. Then, Tritiya Vibhakti will start. Before that, I would like to remind you once. See, here is something. Always subject of a sentence will be in Prathama Vibhakti. That we have seen. Subject, for example, Saha as subject. Okay. Then, Khadati is a verb. Okay. So, Saha Khadati. Saha whatever. Phalam Khadati maybe. We'll take Phalam. So, Saha Phalam Khadati. Even if this object is in Napumsakalinga or whichever the linga, this verb is connected with only the subject, with the subject. So, Saha Khadati. That we need to remember. Then, depending on the speaker, subject will be decided whether to be in singular. Yeah, the speaker, he is referring to a singular. Then, sentence will go as singular. If he is referring to a plural, then it will be used as plural. Okay. The subject and the verb will go in handed. So, I cannot say Saha Khadanti. Why? Only one boy is there in the subject. If I say plural, then he is eating. That is true in English translation. But the meaning will become, when we see in Sanskrit, Saha Khadanti will become, it's saying like only one boy. And when we are ending, many are eating. So, the both won't go properly. So, that is how the usages will go wrong. So, we should know that verb and the subject, the both of them are in the same this one, vachana, singular or plural, which means ekavachana or bahuvachana. So if subject is in singular, then verb also will be in singular. These are all the basic things. When we have started learning Prathama Vibhakti, we have seen that. Now what is there in Tritiya Vibhakti? Tritiya Vibhakti, some major points are there. This vibhakti is called instrumental case. In English, we can say instrumental case. Why it is instrument? It's like instruments. I'm doing something like with this thing. Or I'm going with someone. I'm going by a vehicle. That moment, I'm going to use this Tritiya Vibhakti or instrumental case. So, in English, we use by, with. All these words sometimes we use. Okay. So, when we are using these words in Sanskrit, the same meaning word, the same meaning will be given by Tritiya Vibhakti. Okay. Again, how many instruments are used by the speaker? Depending on that, Vachanam will be fixed. See, for example, one word I'll take, for example, Vahanam. Okay. Spoon is here in this example. I'll take spoon in spoon, or a spoon is called Chamasaha in Sanskrit. Okay. Chamasaha. How to use Chamasena? You need to remember that table, Chamasena. So, I will eat by a spoon. So, Aham Chamasena Khadami. Aham Chamasena Khadami. If I am eating with many spoons, then again this will become plural. It won't stay like this. It will become plural one. That we need to see. And again, just because I am using instrumental case, the subject and the verb, nothing. They don't have to do anything with this. Subject and the verb will remain same. Between these two, we are putting these kind of vibhaktis, other vibhaktis. Aham khadami, that is right. So, chamasena is added one. For example, phalam. Aham phalam khadami. Phalam is same. Aham and khadami both are in hand. So, I'll tell in this way. Aham phalam or annam. Aham annam chamasena khadami. I'll eat rice by spoon. Or aham annam hastena khadami. I'll eat by my hand, with my hand, in that way. So this is the usage of Tritiya Vibhakti. Some rules, all of them are superficially. So in when we go to detail study, then we can understand the exceptional words, how to use them in that way. So yes, Tritiya Vibhakti, how gets ena or aya, how ena. If the word is in male or masculine gender, ena. How, for example, I'll say Ramaha, Pulinga, right? So Ramena should happen. Then if it is in Napumsakalinga, Phalam is Napumsakalinga word, then Phalena, right? Ena has added at the end. If the word is in Strilinga, for example, Sita, if I write, so Aya, how to write first? Sitaya. So Aya at the end, that will become an instrument. So okay, fine. Which gets ena or aya in Pullinga and in Strilinga. Okay. That will become instrumental case. Depending on gender, last part of the word will say, depending on the gender. In the previous part, when we were studying Dvitiya, they need not to be, we didn't see much. Why? Because it could be any word, just we need to add. So add ma, then it will become Dvitiya Vibhakti. It was the case. For example, Ramaha, Ramam, Sita, Sitam, that's all it was. But here, in Tritiya Vibhakti, if it is Pullinga, then ena. If it is Strilinga, then aya. That is how similarities we can see throughout the words, apart from exceptional cases. So the same thing, subject is same, it will be decided by the speaker. Subject and the verb will go hand in hand, that is right. If subject is in singular, then verb also will be in singular. These are all same rules for all. But here, first two points, first one and second point, these two things you need to focus on. Okay. So aham vahanena gachami, okay. Ramaha vahanena gachati, okay. That is how the Tritiya Vibhakti usages will be. See some examples. You can see here one boy is going, so you can take saha or balakaha. Vahanena gachati, who is going, then balakaha or balaha, you can see balaha vahanena gachati. Then hastena khadati, here is a boy, he is eating something. So hastena khadati, he is not using the spoon, okay, it's over here. So hastena khadati. Then dandena tadayati, if someone is hitting someone with a stick, so dandena tadayati, tadayati is hitting someone. See banena hataha, here in this part you can see he is throwing an arrow and he is dead over there. So banena hataha. Then simhena hataha, just think that a lion is eating someone or killing someone, then simhena hataha. Chamasena khadati, again he is not using his hands but he is using chamasa, okay. So chamasena khadati, this is how we need to use Tritiya Vibhakti in the Sanskrit sentences. Then one more major point is there. What is that? When we are using saha, sakam and sardam, or I can say in this way, if I need to say with someone is, or a boy is going with someone, with that time also we need to use Tritiya Vibhakti only. But to say with, what are the words? Then these three are the words to show or to say that I am using with. Saha, it is not, there is a difference between two saha. Saha which means he, saha which means with, sakam with only, sardham also with only. For example, how balakaha gachati, balakaha mitrena saha, with a friend, mitrena. See, with Tritiya Vibhakti we need to use this saha or sakam, sardham, whichever the words. So mitrena gachami, it cannot happen. So mitrena saha, with him. Ramena sakam chalami, just if you write ramena chalami or aham ramena chalami or saha ramena chalati, Rama will become an instrument. But here Rama is not instrument here, but with him you are going, so sakam or saha or sardham. Then Rameshena sardham agamisham. I'll come with Ramesh. Then here, Sitaya saha ramaha vanamasam. See, Sitaya aya, because it's a strilinga. So, Sitaya saha, with Sita, Rama is going to forest. Sitaya saha ramaha vanavasam gachati. Okay. Then, Balikaya saha mitram gachati. A friend, mitram is in Napumsakalinga. Okay. It's not boy or girl or whatever. Unless the speaker is going to reveal the mitram is referring to what, then we don't know whether the mitram, the word is referring to a boy or a girl or a neutral gender word. Okay. So, Balikaya saha mitram gachati. Balikaya saha mitram Sita gachati. Balikaya saha mitram Radha gachati. In that way, we need to use the with word. Saha, sakam or sardham, whatever the thing. So, but how to use aham is the point again. When we are using aham, so we know that depending on the subject, verb will be decided. So, I have used here. For example, I can write again Ramaha only. Ramaha gachati, right? Rama is going. Then, so instead of Rama, I am using aham. So, aham is in which one, which part? Aham gachami, I should say, because aham is in Uttama Purusha, right? So, but Ramaha is in Prathama Purusha, we know that, first person, third person and first person. So, aham gachami, Ramaha gachati. So, this is how we need to use the verbs. So, when we are using aham as subject, then gachami, ami will happen, chalami will happen. Okay, this is the major rules, or these are all the important things to remember when we are constructing Tritiya Vibhakti sentences. We have seen now how to use Tritiya Vibhakti. See, the with the sentences also we have seen how to use Tritiya Vibhakti sentences. Now I am telling about Chaturthi Vibhakti. So here what you are seeing, this already we have discussed, but you need to remember. That's the reason I am going to give the same this part, whatever you are seeing over here, from here to here, this is same. For every sentence, in every case, we are keeping this rule as a major one. Okay, like for example, subject like Prathama Vibhakti, the same subject and verb will go hand in hand. That is the same rule, and singular plural same rule. Okay, subject will be in Prathama Vibhakti only. All these rules are same. Between verb and the subject, just we are adding other cases. That's all the difference. Then how Chaturthi Vibhakti deals, we are seeing over here. This Vibhakti is called dative case also. In English, we use two or four. For example, I am giving a pen or I am giving book to my friend, to someone. I am writing a letter to my friend. I am giving something to someone, two or four. When I am using these two words in English, that time I should use Chaturthi Vibhakti. Okay. So, how the numbers, see, like how I am giving to only one person. Then what will happen? That only one person will be in singular. If I am distributing something to many, then that Chaturthi Vibhakti word will be in plural. That is how the usages will be, or vachana will be fixed. So here example, I give a pen to my friend. So I can say, instead of that, I'll write here, aham, okay, aham dadami, I am giving what? I am giving patram, letter. Aham patram dadami. So it is dvitiya vibhakti. Aham patram hastena dadami. Letter. I am not going to do any courier or post, whatever the thing. Just I am giving a letter by my hands. So aham patram hastena dadami. See, dvitiya vibhakti, objective case. Hastena, instrumental case. See, aham dadami is remaining. Aham patram aham dadami. What? Kim dadami? Aham patram dadami. Kena dadami? Aham patram hastena dadami. So, kasmai dadami? Kasmai, you can remember all this questionnaire over there. Aham patram hastena ramaya. This is Chaturthi Vibhakti. Aham patram hastena ramaya dadami. By using all the three cases here, Dvitiya Vibhakti, Tritiya Vibhakti, Chaturthi Vibhakti, using all these three cases, I am constructing a Sanskrit sentence. Aham patram hasteena ramaya dadami. Instead of that, if I say only chaturthi vibhakti sentence, then aham ramaya dadami. That's all. I am giving to Rama. What and all later. Aham giving to Rama. Aham ramaya dadami. What are you giving? I am giving a letter to Rama. Aham patram ramaya dadami. Oh, you are sending by post. No. By hand. I am aham patram ramaya hasteena dadami. This is how the usage. Or aham, like how aya will come here, that we'll see. See, a word which gets aya or ayai at the end, that will become dative. So general last part of the word will change. How? For example, Ramaha will become Ramaya. Sita will become Sitayai. Stree Pullinga and Streelinga. Aya will be in Pullinga. Ayai will be in Streelinga. This is the major rule. Then if it is Phalam, that also Phalaya only. We need not to worry for neutral gender, because neutral gender and masculine gender, both will work almost same. Somewhere some changes will be there, but otherwise same as it is. Ramaya, Phalaya, same. Sitayai Dadami. And other rules are same. Speaker should decide whether singular or plural. For example, I am not giving to only one boy. So many of them are there. Then that Ramaya won't happen, but something else will come in plural. Okay. These rules are same as it is. This you need to remember. First one and second one. These two sentences you need to focus on. The example, if we see, Saha Dadati. See, Saha Dadati. Saha kim dadati? Saha pustakam dadati. To whom? Then Saha kasmai dadati? Saha Ramaya pustakam dadati. Okay, this is how the usage. Sa dadati. Again, here same. Sa dadati. Samitraya patrikam dadati. This girl is giving a paper to her friend. This girl, sa, strilinga. So, sa mitraya patrikam dadati. Then here, Sita is here, you can see. Sita ramaya malam sthapayati. Sthapayati is just putting on. So, Sita sthapayati. Kim sthapayati? Malam, garland. So, to whom? Ramaya, aya. Got it? The same way, Krishna shravayati. Shravayati is, which means listening. Krishna shravayati. What? Venunadam, flute, sound of flute, or flute sound, whatever you call. So to whom? Radhayai. So Radhayai, ayai, is strilinga. Sitayai, the same way. Okay, we have seen that in the previous slide, how to use like aya or ayai. Aya ramaya sitayai, krishnaya radhayai. So Krishnaha shravayati. Kim shravayati? Krishna Venunadam Shravayati. Kasmai Shravayati? Radhayai. So Krishna Radhayai Venunadam Shravayati. This is how the sentence. Then Ramaha Dadati. What? Ramaha Padukam Dadati. To whom? Bharataya. So Ramaha Bharataya Padukam Dadati. This is how. See, one, two. Objective and dative, two cases. If at all you want to add instrumental case also, then you can add for the last sentence. For example, I'm showing Hastena. How? Ramaha Dadati. Kim Dadati? Ramaha Padukam Dadati. How or by what he is giving? Ramaha Hastena Padukam Dadati. To whom? Ramaha Padukam Hastena Bharataya Dadati. Okay, let us think. Instead of all these subjects, whatever I have written, Rama, Krishna, Sita, Sa, Saha, whatever. Instead of that, I am using Aham. What will happen? Definitely, the verb will change. Instead of Dadati, Dadami would have happened. Aham, Saha, Dadati, Aham, Dadami. Sa, Dadati, Aham, Dadami. Sita, Sthapayati, Aham, Sthapayami. Krishna, Shravayati, Aham, Shravayami. Ramaha dadati, aham dadami. That's the difference between the subject aham, because aham is first person, and all of them are whatever you can see over here, they will come under third person. So Uttama Purusha is Aham, Prathama Purusha is all the other things. Okay, you can see here Vedunada and Malam Sthapayati and Patrikam Dadati. These are the major points. This is how we need to construct sentences in fourth case, Chaturthi Vibhakti. Yes, some sentence still you can make. How? Aham, Khadami, Arohami, Vadami, Pibami, Dadami. Okay, Marayami, Tadayami. Should be Tadayami. Okay, then Gachami, Kathayami, whatever. Then Saha, Khadati, Arohati, as it is. Sa, same. Eshaha, same. Esha, same. Bhavan, Bhavati, also same. But the meaning Aham, which means I am, and saha, sa, eshaha, esha, third person. Bhavan and Bhavati, you, second person. So which means Bhavati is in Srilinga, Bhavan is in Pullinga. We need to know. I cannot say Bhavan to a girl. You, when I am referring to a girl, I should not say Bhavan Balika. I should say Bhavati Balika. And when I am referring to a boy, I cannot say Bhavati Ramaha. I should say Bhavan Ramaha. That is an important point. So when you are using Aham, then Ami will happen over here. And other than that, whenever using any of these, Ti only will remain. So now you are having verbs and the subjects. Aham is a subject and all of them are verbs. Aham Khadami, you have done one sentence. So question now, Aham Khadami, write one sentence. Then question there, Aham Kim Khadami. Then answer there, Aham Annam Khadami. Okay, again question there, Kena Khadami, Aham Kena Khadami. Then answer, Aham Hastena Annam Khadami. Okay, that is how. And try to put Chaturthi Vibhakti also. Okay, Kasmai Khadati, Aham, Aham Kasmai Khadami. Okay, to whom you are eating? Aham Annam Hastena Udaraya Khadami, or Vardhanaya Khadami, to grow. Okay, I'll write here. You can see Aham is here, Khadati is there. I'll make it Khadami. So Aham is remaining. Okay, I'll write here only, Aham Annam Khadami. First question is Kim. Aham Kim Khadami, Aham Annam Khadami. Aham Kena Annam Khadami, Aham Hastena Annam Khadami. Aham Kasmai Khadami, Kasmai, for what? Okay, Aham Vardhanaya, to grow. Aham Vardhanaya Annam Hastena Khadami. All the vibhaktis are used in this sentence. The same way, if you take Saha, then Saha Arohati is climbing up. So Saha Arohati. Saha Kim Arohati? Saha Vriksham Arohati. Saha Kena Arohati? Padena. Saha Padena Vriksham Arohati. Okay, for what? Saha Vriksham Padena Phalaya, to that, to get that. Phalaya Arohati, Phalartham Arohati. So that is how we need to use all these subjects and all these verbs in our sentences by using at least two vibhaktis. Dvitiya will be there. Dvitiya can be, Dvitiya vibhakti can be added in every sentences. But Tritiya you try to find, and Chaturthi you try to find. If at all you are using all of them, all Dvitiya, Tritiya, Chaturthi, all three of them, that's great. If at all minimum you are using two, that is also okay. But only one Dvitiya you are using, that is average. If at all still you are using Saha Pibati, no usages of any cases, no usage, that should not happen. So you need to practice by using at least two vibhaktis in between subject and the verb. For example, Saha Pibati. Saha Kim Pibati? Saha Jalam Pibati. So you have used one, that is okay state. Saha Jalam Kena Pibati? Saha Jalam Hastena Pibati. Let us take Hastena. That is good. Saha Jalam Hastena, because you use one and two. Two vibhaktis you have used. If at all you use third one, chaturthi vibhakti also, again, saha jalam hastena, okay, vardhanaya, whatever you take, pibati, then you have used third word or third, fourth case also. This is best. So, if at all you are using saha pibati, then it is not at all good. Okay, which means fail. Let us take fail. And one, okay. Then two you are using, good, no problem. Then you are using all three, that is best. See, find your category and construct at least 15 sentences altogether. 15 is minimum, more than that, no problem. Okay, we'll see in the next class. Thank you.